A Lancaster County woman is among an elite group. She is one of 10 finalists nationwide in a first-of-its-kind baking contest.
As 8 on Your Side medical reporter Susan Shapiro explains, her interest in the contest came about because of her own medical condition.
I sang his sad, sad song.
Christina Fidler is homeschooling her two young children. Sometimes the lessons include cooking and baking, gluten-free recipes. The 30-year-old Ephrata woman says she is gluten intolerant. The condition causes gastrointestinal problems from foods processed with the protein found in wheat, barley, and rye.
You pretty much have to cook from scratch, which is healthy. It's a healthy way to eat, but it's also very time-consuming.
Even though the gluten meal sometimes can be a little bit bland at times, she always added something that really made the taste really good.
Christina decided to enter Betty Crocker's first ever gluten-free recipe contest. It required using a Betty Crocker gluten-free mix. General Mills and other companies are now making a number of different gluten-free mixes. This cake mix contains rice flour instead of wheat flour. But as you can see, they're about double the price of traditional cake mixes.
That just makes it more simple and easy to make cupcakes or something, you know, that you can just throw together and you don't have to make from scratch.
Christina made cupcakes using the gluten-free cake mix.
You want to dip them?
She then put together a rich icing to turn them into tiramisu cupcakes.
Tiramisu is one of my favorite desserts, and eating gluten-free, I hadn't had it in a long time, so I thought I'd come up with my own recipe.
Her family loves the cupcakes, and so did the Betty Crocker judges. She's one of the 10 finalists in the contest. Now it's up to the public to pick the winner. In Ephrata, Susan Shapiro, News 8.
All right, now you can vote for Christina's cupcakes or any of the other 9 entries. The winner will receive a $5,000 prize and the chance to be on a Betty Crocker mix. So we have set up a link for you on WGAL.com. And here they are. Look, Susan brought them back.
Yeah, look wonderful.
I think you'll make short work of that tonight.
Well, looks beautiful. I'm tempted.
Yeah, they look great.
The way those kids
we're
are going at
it. We'll keep our fingers crossed.
All right.